Hey guys, Matt from ABICOR Binzel. Let's talk your welding nozzles, and specifically, how your welding nozzle affects your welding gun performance. There are all kinds of nozzle materials, styles, shapes, and recesses, and the choice of nozzle that you make has an enormous impact on your welding gun performance and the lifespan of that consumable. So with that said, let's dive right in and explain. Let's start with your nozzle material. You're gonna see almost universally three different kinds of nozzle materials out in the market, either a brass nozzle, copper nozzle, or nickel-plated nozzle. And the choice usually depends on your parameters and also your process. So brass is gonna be one of the more common nozzle materials you're gonna see out in the market. It has good spatter resistance at low parameters. Once you go up to higher parameters, you're gonna see a brass nozzle start to lose a lot of its properties. If you get to a high enough parameter, you'll even notice your brass nozzle will start to melt or even shatter because it just can't withstand that much heat. If you're gonna take a step up in parameters, you're gonna wanna move up to a copper nozzle. Copper is gonna be another really common material you see out there in the marketplace. Copper has higher thermal dissipation than brass. It works a lot better at a higher parameters, and it also has better durability than a brass nozzle. If you're looking to step up even further with your welding gun nozzle, look no further than going with nickel-plated nozzles. Nickel-plated nozzles are gonna give you the best nozzle durability and the least spatter adhesion of any other nozzle materials that you can choose. Nickel plate is always going to be plated to a copper nozzle, so you're gonna get all of those really good, durable copper nozzle properties on top of even more spatter resistance because the nickel keeps the inside and the outside of the nozzle cooler. And while your filler metal is passing through, that means you're gonna get less spatter adhesion inside your nozzle and around your contact tip. This is the same premise for why your water-cooled consumables will adhere less spatter than air-cooled consumables. Okay, so moving on from materials, let's talk about styles. So with nozzle styles, you're gonna be talking about a threaded style nozzle or a slip-on style nozzle. This is a choice that you're going to make when you choose your gun in the first place, but knowing the pros and cons of each will hopefully help you when you're looking at new equipment or looking to get another gun in the future. Let's start with threaded nozzles. Threaded nozzles are gonna give you a more secure connection on your MIG gun because of the threads. It'll also help seat your nozzle at the right place on your MIG gun every time because you're threading all the way through to the end. Threaded nozzles also help keep your consumables concentric, which is really important for gas flow. And threading won't allow any of your consumables to sit off center as a result. One of the downsides of a threaded nozzle is it can be difficult to replace if spatter binds inside the threads. One way to overcome that with the threaded nozzle is to use coarse threading with your nozzles, and that will allow you to unbind all that spatter and replace your nozzle relatively easily. So let's move on to slip-on style nozzles. That's the other style you're going to see. Slip-on style nozzles are really good for overhead applications as well as applications that produce a lot of spatter. So slip-on style nozzles are good because there's no threading like with a threaded nozzle. When you're trying to take your nozzle out, it won't potentially get caught inside the threads and rip off your diffuser or your contact tip. Simply just take a slip-on nozzle off, replace, and then start welding again. Another benefit of a slip-on style nozzle is they're typically going to be lower priced because slip-on style nozzles are single-piece construction as opposed to a threaded style nozzle, which has more components machined into it in order to achieve that threading. Some of the drawbacks of slip-on style nozzles is because it's a slip-on, it can sometimes cause your consumables to sit off center. Also, if it's not seated all the way back, you can experience gas loss and as a result, experience porosity in your weld. Also, the O-ring, sometimes the O-ring can fail on your slip-on style nozzle. That can cause your nozzle to just fall off while it's in operation. For automated and robotic applications, if you're using a torch cleaning station, slip-on style nozzles are typically not recommended because the nozzle can spin with the reaming blade while the reamer's in action. So let's move on to nozzle shapes. So with shapes, you're typically gonna be talking about either a conical, cylindrical, or bottle form style nozzle. And for extreme tight access, you also can use a tapered nozzle. Conical nozzles are gonna be the most popular nozzles that you're gonna see out there, and for good reason. Conical nozzles are considered the best nozzles in terms of gas flow to your weld piece. The reason being is the inner conical shape of these nozzles actually accelerates gas into the weld piece while you're striking an arc. That keeps your gas column more stable, less turbulence, so you're getting more gas coverage while you're striking the arc. Conical nozzles are also extremely useful if you're gonna be welding with any sort of zinc coating. The reason being is that a zinc coating tends to produce a more explosive and larger spatter than other metal materials. And a conical nozzle actually allows the reaming blade to reach up into the nozzle and get those large spatters out, provided you're using a two-stroke reaming process with an air blast. And that reason is because, unlike with the cylindrical nozzle where it can just kind of sit everywhere, and when you put the reamer blade up, it'll actually gunk the spatter into your diffuser. The conical shape actually allows these spatters to sit sort of in these clearance areas, so when you're reaming, you can get that spatter out. Conical nozzles really offer very few drawbacks. It can be argued for automated applications that conical nozzles produce less reaming efficiency than cylindrical nozzles, for instance, because the front edge of the nozzle and the partial tip length means the reaming blade can't quite access all the way in there. But if you're using a single piece construction conical nozzle, like this one I'm holding here, which is for our ABIROB A500, you can overcome that potential downside for a conical shaped nozzle. Another consideration you wanna make with the conical nozzle is think about your contact tip diameter against your inner diameter of your nozzle. So if you're using a 12 millimeter inner diameter nozzle, you can use, for instance, an 8 millimeter outer diameter contact tip because you're going to get enough gas clearance to cover your weld appropriately with enough gas. But if you use a larger contact tip, for instance, a 10 millimeter outer diameter with this 12 millimeter inner diameter, you're going to get less gas flow into the weld, which is going to cause porosity, obviously lower gas flow, and eventually spatter bridging inside your nozzle. After conical nozzles, cylindrical is going to be another very common shape you're going to see out there in the field. Cylindrical nozzle is a very good nozzle to use if you're going to utilize an oversized contact tip like an M10 or an M12 style. Reason being is because cylindrical nozzles with oversized contact tips will still allow enough gas to get through and onto the weld piece, so you'll get the appropriate amount of gas coverage. Cylindrical nozzles are also very good to use in high amperage applications because it can support a big spike or increase in gas flow, again, without causing porosity. One of the drawbacks or limits more so of a cylindrical nozzle is going to be it's not appropriate to use with an M6 or an M8 style tip because that would produce too much gas flow into your weld piece and you would get porosity for an entirely different reason. So just something to keep in mind. So the other style nozzle you're going to see a lot of is a bottle form style nozzle. There's also tapered style nozzles which have very much the same function as a bottle form style nozzle, and that's to access difficult to reach joints. Tapered is going to be specifically for narrow gap. Bottle form will have a little bit more application, but premise very much the same. Some of the drawbacks to bottle form nozzles is they're obviously very prone to spatter bridging because of the small outer diameter opening at the front end of the workpiece. They also can be difficult to ream because of that, again, small outer diameter at the front end. I should note though that for any bottle form style nozzle for ABICOR Binzel, there are reaming blades available to reach through the outer diameter all the way to the gas ports. The most important thing to consider when looking at your welding nozzle is your bore size. If you're gonna use a bottle form or a conical style nozzle, you're gonna be looking at a bore size of 3/8 to 5/8 inch. Any larger bore size, you're probably gonna be stepping up to a cylindrical style nozzle. The most important thing to consider is you wanna choose the largest bore size possible without compromising joint access. That's gonna give you the best gas coverage, it's going to produce the least amount of spatter buildup, and it's going to require the least amount of maintenance over the life of the nozzle. Lastly, we'll talk about your nozzle recess, which is going to speak to where your contact tip sits in relation to your welding nozzle. Let's start with recessed nozzles. Recessed nozzles allow the contact tip to sit farther back inside the nozzle and increases wire stick out to the workpiece. Recessed nozzles will typically be used for higher amperage and pulse welding applications. Reason being is because this will allow the welding gun to sit farther back from the workpiece while allowing the nozzle to sit at a normal length. This means that the welding torch gets adequate gas coverage to the workpiece while still combating against porosity. A flush nozzle design is where the contact tip sits directly where the nozzle bore opening is. Typically, you would use a flush nozzle for a low amperage short circuit application. Reason being is that a lower amperage means you require less wire stick out, and as a result, you need less gas coverage to produce a quality weld. The biggest drawback you're going to see with a flush nozzle is because the contact tip sits directly at the nozzle bore, it's much more prone to spatter bridging as a result. Stick out nozzles are only recommended for use for a very tight joint or a joint you could not otherwise access with another kind of nozzle. Reason being is because with a stick-out nozzle, the contact tip actually protrudes out of the nozzle bore, and you're relying on that restricted access to pull the gas in order to get adequate gas coverage to produce a quality weld. No matter what type of nozzle you're using for your welding application, you can extend the life of your nozzle by using anti-spatter products to protect your nozzle against spatter buildup. You can use either ceramic sprays or liquids or any other kind of anti-spatter application, and it will extend the life of your nozzle as well as your other MIG welding consumables. If you're looking for more welding tips, tricks, information, how-tos, subscribe to our blog, follow us on our social media channels, or visit us at binzel-abicor.com. This is Matt from ABICOR Binzel. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Have a great day.